Hello everybody, welcome to another CSGO editing tutorial. In this one, I'm going to be doing an updated version of my reshade tutorial. A few things have changed within reshade and some people get confused by it. In this one, I'm going to be going a bit more in depth and explaining a few more things. The first step we need to do is head over to advancedeffects.org and download the latest version of HLE. After that, download the latest reshade installer. You can click the download button here and download through here. Once that is done, head to this GitHub page and download the shaders and textures folder. You can do that by downloading the zip folder here. Once you have those, you can go ahead and extract the HLE folder into its separate folder like so. Once you have that, you can go ahead and create a folder for your reshade. So I'm going to name mine reshade. I recommend placing this somewhere that's easy to access. Once that is done, you put the reshade setup in the folder, like so, as well as the zip. And once you've done that, you can go ahead and extract the shaders and textures folder into the reshade folder you created, like so. And once that is done, you can go ahead and run the reshade setup. And this box should pop up. Just press Ctrl on your keyboard and click select game to install or uninstall from. And once you've done that, you should get two DLL files here. And then go ahead and delete the zip folder and the setup. And once that is done, go ahead and launch HLE like so. Make sure you click yes for updates. Go to tools, developer and custom loader. For program path, what you need to do is locate your csgo.exe. Mine is located on my C drive in my Steam folder. Most people also have it here as well, but you can just locate it wherever you have it installed. For command line, you can go ahead and do a custom resolution. In this case, I'm going to be using a custom resolution of 1600 by 900. You can do the same if you want, but that's really up to you. For DLLs to inject, what we need to do is select AFX hook source to DLL. This will be in your HLE folder. And once you've done that, what you need to do now is inject the reshade32.dll into HLE. And if you have an AMD card, what you need to do is an extra step. If you have an NVIDIA card, you won't need to do this. The extra step is you need to go to your local disk where your Windows is installed. Go to Windows, go down to System32 down here. And then what you need to look for is a DLL file called d3d9.dll, and you need to drag it in like so. That's if you only have an AMD card. If you don't, you don't need to do this step. So I don't have an AMD card, so I'm gonna go and delete that DLL. And once you have that done, you just press OK and CSGO launch. Alright, once CSGO is launched, you should get this Valve anti-cheat message pop up, and you should have saw the little reshade bar pop up on your screen as well. And what you need to do now is press home on your keyboard. This will bring up the reshade menu. Just click continue, and then continue again. Head over to settings, and what I would do is go ahead and set up your binds. The first bind is you can change the overlay keys. So the default key is home. I like to change it back to F11, which was the original key before they changed it. And the effect toggle, I like to change that to F12. This is so you can toggle the effects on and off. I recommend setting this. The effects reload, you don't really need to use this, but you can set up a bind for it as well. And you can also set up a screenshot key if you want. I usually put this at F7. And then I change the screenshot path to my desktop. But this is just a tutorial, so I'm not going to be doing that. And once that is done, you can pretty much leave it and close the reshade menu. Now what you also need to do is head over to your settings and go to video settings. And what you need to do is disable multi-sampling anti-aliasing. Make sure that is turned off, and turn off FXAA anti-aliasing as well. Make sure those two are off. You can pretty much leave everything else on high defaults if you want, depending on how you want your game to look. I recommend always having it on high or very high just to make the game look nicer. You can go ahead and press Shift F2 on your keyboard and load up a demo. but I'm just going to quickly look for a random demo to use for this tutorial. So I'm just going to use one on Cobble that I've used before. Alright, once you've loaded into your demo, you can go ahead and skip to whatever tick you want. Now what you need to do is set up a toggle for your VGUI. I'll put the commands in the description and on the screen now. You can copy them and just copy and paste it into your config. So I'm just going to exec my config like so. And as you can see, when I press my bind, in this case it's set up to F8. You can see my crosshair disappear and appear as I press it. When you use reshade, you need to disable this. And when you disable it, you won't be able to open your console or the demo UI. It just won't open. And so to open it again, you have to re-enable your VGUI and your crosshair should appear again. Alright, so now what we do is open up the reshade menu. My bind is F11. Yours is going to be different depending on what you set it to. And now for your effects search path and texture search path, what you need to do is redirect it to wherever your reshade is. So in this case, I put mine on my desktop, so I'm going to quickly get it. Okay, so what we need to do is grab the directory for the shaders, put that in the effects search path. So we can just copy and paste the directory like so, and paste it in. For texture search paths, what you need to do is just locate the textures folder and set the path like that. And for presets search path, this is only relevant if you have a preset installed or you want to use. I just leave it as the reshade folder like that. And that's pretty much it. And then what you need to do is head over back to the home tab, press finish and press reload. And then you should be able to see all the effects within reshade, which is what you want to see. So now the first thing you want to do is obviously disable the VGUI. So go ahead and press your binds, make sure your crosshair has disappeared like so. And the first thing you want to do is search for display depth and enable that. All right, once that is done, you should see something similar to this. I should see like a 50-50 on your screen. What you need to do to change that is go to preset type and set that to depth map. Now your screen should be like fully black like so. What you need to do is check the box saying use pre-processor definitions like that and click edit global processor pre-processor definitions. And what you need to do is set this to 256, set this to 0, set this to 1, and you might have to reload it like so. And you should be able to see the depth map like this. And once you have this, that means your depth will be working and you can go ahead and disable display depth like that. Now we can go ahead and get started with playing around with the effects. So the main effects you want to be using is definitely depth of fields. So the one I mainly use is Marty McFly, depth of fields. All right, cool. And what you can go ahead and do is play around the settings. So the main one is the manual depth focus. So you can go ahead and play around the different depth of fields like that. Now, as you can see, the view model is actually blurred out as well. You of course don't really want that, especially in edit, because you want that to be in focus. To fix that, what you can do is go into your reshade folder, go to the shaders, search for DOF and open it in something like Notepad++. And what you need to do is search for scene depth. Go down to scene CSC and set this to 0 like so, and go ahead and save it. And then what you need to do is reload it. And as you can see, the view model is no longer blurred. And again, you have to play around the different settings like so, depending on how you want it to look. And you can go ahead and play around all the different settings. So if you want like really nice bokeh and stuff like that. So once you have this fulfilled, another one you want to use is MXAO. That just makes the game look a whole lot nicer. You can go ahead and play around the different settings. You can use the AO/IL channel to play it to see the shading. So if you like bump it up a bit like so, maybe make it a bit darker like that just to make it look nicer. Depending on how good your computer is, it may look a bit weird and pixelated like mine is, as you can see here. And you can change the sample quality. I'm going to turn it to very high, and you also disable that like that, and you can see the shadows and stuff look a lot nicer. My computer's not the great, so it's like a graphical glitch, but yeah, that's pretty normal. And another one you want to be using is FXAA. Go ahead and enable that. This just sharpens the edges a bit. So as you can see, you can go ahead and play other settings. I'm just gonna leave it default because I'm not gonna be playing around with all different settings at the moment. And another one is SMAA. Enable that as well. And again, you can go ahead and play with the different settings. You can see the different debug modes to get into full detail like so. You can go fully in depth with this and play with all the settings. There's also adaptive sharpen, that's also pretty good to use. There's curves, you go low contrast mode for better color correction and stuff like that. Also HDR mode as well. So yeah, that's pretty much it. You can go ahead and play around with the different settings, make it look like how you want it to. And if you want to disable effects, as you did in the start of the tutorial, you can go ahead and set up your bind for the toggle. So there's a difference between reshade on and off. You can see which one looks a lot nicer. Although I might have messed up a bit, it's a bit dark, but it's just a tutorial. And if you press the VGUI toggle, your entire screen will blur because of the depth of field. And of course you don't have to use depth of field, you can use something else if you want. But if you want to use the console, you go ahead and toggle the effects on and off with your toggle key and turn on the VGA again, and you can go ahead and use the console. You can use the demo UI again. And yeah, that's pretty much it. So yeah, and I'll see you guys in the next tutorial.